गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक टू इंग्लिश क्लास. स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू टेक अ लिटिल ब्रेक फ्रॉम लिटरेचर पार्ट. इंस्टेड ऑफ दैट वी आर गोइंग टू सी अ न्यू चैप्टर इन ग्रामर, दैट इज सब्जेक्ट एंड प्रेडिकेट. ओके स्टूडेंट्स, ऑल ऑफ यू टेक द चैप्टर नंबर 7, सब्जेक्ट एंड प्रेडिकेट इन योर ग्रामर बुक एंड टेक अ पेंसिल एंड इरेजर ऑल्सो. स्टूडेंट्स, बिफोर गोइंग टू सी दिस कॉन्सेप्ट, Let us discuss about sentences and its uses. Okay, what do you mean by sentence? Yes, you're right. A sentence is a group of words. A sentence is a group of words which makes complete sense. It means when we combine or when we grouping the words and it makes the sentence meaningful. It makes the sentence meaningful. Without meaningful, it is not a sentence. And one more thing, you should keep it in your mind. All sentences begin with a capital letter. If you are writing any sentence, the first letter should be in capital letter. Okay? Whatever you are writing, the first letter should be in capital letter. And the sentence can be end. The sentence can end with a full stop or a question mark or an exclamation mark. Students, a sentence is a group of words which makes the sentence meaningful. And it starts with a capital letter and ends with a full stop or a question mark or an exclamation mark. Okay students, let us see some examples here. Look at this group of words. Group of words means sentence. Look at the sentences. On the beach. It is a sentence. It is not a meaningful sentence. Okay, on the beach. There is no meaning in the given sentence. Let's move to the next one. My grandfather likes. We can say that it is a group of words, but it is not a meaningful sentence because there is no meaning in the given sentences. So what we have to do now, if we add some more extra words to these words, it become meaningful. If we add some words to the given sentence, they become meaningful. Let us see here. We built a sand castle on the beach. Already we have seen that on the beach, we said that it is not a sentence, so that's why we added some more words. We built a sand castle on the beach. Now it become a meaningful sentence. Let us see the second one. My grandfather likes to read. Yes, there is a meaning in the given sentence, so that's why we are saying that sentence is a group of words. It makes complete sense. Okay students, let us learn more about sentences with the help of given example. Let us see what are they. Look at these group of words. The cat on sleeping the sofa is. I the kept in the fridge butter. We can say that these are group of words, but we cannot say it is a meaningful sentence because there is no meaning. Just words are there. Just group of words are there, but there is no meaning, and the words are not arranged in proper order also, so that's why they do not make complete sense. Now what we have to do, we have to arrange these words in proper order, then only they become meaningful. What we have to do, we arrange the words correctly and they become meaningful. Okay, let's arrange the first one. The cat is sleeping on the sofa. Now students, now it became a complete and meaningful sentence because because the sentence is giving some information to us, like the cat is sleeping on the sofa and there is a meaning also. Let's arrange the second one. I kept the butter in the fridge. Yes, in the second statement also we have arranged in proper order and it gives the information as I kept the butter in the fridge. Okay students, let's do the first exercise. Let us see what is it. Tick the group of words that make sense. Already we know that a group of words must be in proper order to make complete and meaningful sentence. What I said, a sentence is a group of words which makes and which gives meaningful and complete information. Okay, let us see what is the exercise. Tick the group of words that make sense. It means tick the sentences which makes complete and meaningful sentence. Let us see the first one. Our has 8 solar system planets. Is it a sentence? No, it is not a sentence. We can say that it is a group of words, but the words are not arranged in proper order and it is not giving a proper information and meaningful information. So what do you want to do? You want to put a cross mark inside the first box. Let's move to the second one. We live on the planet Earth. Is it a sentence? Yes, it is a sentence. It is a meaningful sentence and all the words are arranged in proper order. So tick on the second box. Let's move to the third one. Jupiter largest the is planet. Yes, we can say that the third one is also not correct answer because all the words are not arranged in proper order and it is not giving proper and complete information and it is not a complete sentence also. So put a cross mark inside the third box. Let's move to the last one. Mercury is the smallest planet. Is it a sentence? Yes. And the last one is also a correct sentence because it is arranged in proper order and it is a meaningful sentence also. So put a tick mark on the fourth box. Students, do it neatly and clearly in your grammar book. Okay students, let's do the second exercise. That is, arrange the following group of words to form sentences. Remember to begin with a capital letter and put a full stop or a question mark at the end. Now what you want to do students, here they have given group of words but it is not arranged in proper order. We have to arrange these words in proper order and remember that we should always start the first letter in capital and end of the statement we put a full stop or a question mark. Okay, let's do the first one. Look here, the group of words are I bought yesterday computer new. It is not a meaningful sentence. Now we have to arrange these words in proper order and keep it in your mind that first letter should be in capital letter. So see here, I bought a new computer yesterday. I should be in capital letter. I bought a new computer yesterday. End of the statement, put a full stop. Okay, because the statement is over and it is just a information, so we have to put a full stop at the end of the sentence. Let's move to the second one. She in school studies St. Peter's. The words are also not arranged in proper, so we have to arrange it in proper order. So how can we arrange she? The first letter S should be in capital letter. She studies. Next we have to put verb studies. She studies in St. Peter's school because what is the school name? St. Peter. So it is a proper noun. We know very well that proper noun always starts with capital letter. So St. Peter's school, that's all. She studies in St. Peter's school. So put a full stop at the end of the statement. Let's move to the third one. I funny am book reading a. How can we change this into complete sentence? I am reading a funny book. I am reading a funny book. So I should be in capital letter. I am reading a funny book. End of the sentence, we should put a full stop. Students, write neatly. Okay students, let's move to the fourth one. Let us see the fun we on ad ride. We know very well that it is not a complete sentence, so we have to arrange these words in complete proper order. Okay, let's do that. First, we have to write V. In the word V, the letter W should be in capital. Okay. Next, we have to write verb. Add fun. We add fun on the ride. Okay, end of the sentence, we put, you have to put full stop. Because it is a normal sentence, it is telling information. So that's why we are putting full stop on the end of the statement. If it is a question, end of the statement, you should put question mark. Okay, let's move to the fifth one. Is Mr. Tendulkar walks takes for dog? So first we have to write the name of the person. Okay, Mr. Tendulkar. Mr. Tendulkar takes his dog. Takes verb. In the sentence, the verb is takes. Takes his dog for walks. So Mr. Tendulkar takes his dog for walks. End of the statement, put a full stop. Let's move to the next one. A dog is in the front yard there. So simple, it is a simple sentence. I think you should write, there is a dog. There is a dog in the front yard. That's all. The letter T should be in capital letter, because already I said that whatever we are starting, we are writing in the first letter should be in capital. End of the statement, we have to put a full stop. And one more thing, if the word is a for example, if it is a interrogative sentence, it means it is a questioning sentence, end of the statement, put a question mark. If it is not a questioning sentence, just put a full stop. Okay, students, write neatly in your grammar book. We have completed the first 6 sentences. Remaining, you should try in your grammar book. Write neatly. Use pencil, not pen. Students, let us see what is subject and predicate. A sentence is divided into 2 parts. We can divide a sentence into 2 parts. One is subject and another one is predicate. Okay. The subject. What do you mean by subject? A subject. The subject tells us who or what the sentence is about. It tells us who or what the sentence is about. About who or what. This is known as subject. What do you mean by predicate? It tells something about the subject. It tells something about the subject. What do you mean by subject? The subject of the sentence is what or whom the sentence is about. This is known as subject. What do you mean by predicate? The predicate tells something about the subject. Or otherwise, we can say that a predicate is the part of a sentence that tells what the subject is doing or what the subject is. Okay, students, one way to remember that the difference between subject and predicate is, the subject will be a noun or pronoun. What is the difference between subject and predicate? Subject will be a noun or pronoun, and the predicate will contain remaining the part of a sentence, what the subject is doing or what the subject is. Let us see an example here. The man stood at the gate. What is the example? The man stood at the gate. Actually, what is the sentence is about? Already said that the subject tells us who or what. Here, who stood at the gate? The man. So the subject is the man. So remaining parts of the sentence is predicate, because it tells about the man. So the man is the subject, stood at the gate is predicate. Okay, students, let us learn more about subject and predicate with the help of given example. Let us see what are they. Look here, they have given some examples and they differentiated subject and predicate. Look here, the chef is cooking pasta and chicken. This is the sentence, okay? The chef is cooking pasta and chicken. Who is cooking pasta and chicken? The chef. Already we said that subject tells us who or what the subject is. Here, who is cooking pasta and chicken? The chef. So the chef is the subject. Is cooking pasta and chicken. It means it tells about the chef. So that's why it is predicate. Subject is a subject will be noun or pronoun, and remaining parts of the sentence is predicate. Let's move to the second one. The prisoner was jailed for 10 years. Who was jailed for 10 years? The prisoner. So the prisoner is the subject. Remaining was jailed for 10 years is the predicate. Let's move to the third one. Tom Hanks is a well-known actor. Who is a well-known actor? Tom Hanks. So is the subject. Remaining predicate. Remaining is a well-known actor is the predicate. The car is driving at a great speed. Already said that subject is who or what. So the car is the subject. Remaining is driving at a great speed. So it is the predicate. And one more thing. Subject usually comes before the predicate, but sometimes it may come after the predicate. What they are telling, usually most of the time the subject will comes before the predicate. Sometimes it may come after the predicate. Okay students, let's do an exercise related to subject and predicate. Let us see. Circle the subject and underline the predicate in the following sentences. They have given some sentences. What we have to do means we have to read the sentence properly and then circle the subject. Circle the subject and underline the predicate. Keep it in your mind that circle the subject. Just circle the subject and underline the predicate. Let us see the first one. Sea water is not fit for drinking. What is the first sentence? Sea water is not fit for drinking. What is the subject in the first sentence? Sea water. Because what is not fit for drinking here? Sea water. So it is the subject. So circle the words sea water. Subject. The subject in the first sentence is sea water. And remaining is predicate. So underline. Is not fit for drinking is the predicate. Let's move to the second one. Betty goes to the library every day. So what is subject? What is the subject in the second sentence? Yes. Who goes library every day? Betty. So Betty is the subject. So underline. She circle the word Betty. Remaining you should underline. Goes to the library every day. You should underline. And the next one is, we sing carols during Christmas. We sing carols during Christmas. So which is the subject in the third sentence? Already I said that you should keep one thing in your mind. Subject will be noun or pronoun. So we is the subject. So circle the word we. Remaining you should underline. And the fourth one is, we will visit America in the evening. Who will visit America in the evening? We will visit. So you should circle the word we, because that is the subject. And remaining you should underline. You draw a big line, okay? And the last one is, we keep our money in the bank. We keep our money in the bank. So I think you know very well that which is the subject in the fifth one. Yes, you are right that we is the subject. So what you want to do now? You should circle the word we. And remaining? Yes, you are right. Remaining, you should draw a line. You should underline the predicate. Okay, students, we have completed the first 5 sentences. Remaining, you should try in your grammar book. Already I said that use pencils, not pen, okay? Okay students, already we have completed 3 exercises. Now we are going to do the next exercise, that is match the subjects with the predicates to form meaningful sentences. Here they have separated into 2 columns. One is one for the first column is subject column and the second column is predicate column. Now we have to match the subject with the predicate, then only they become meaningful sentences. Okay students, let us see how to do. The first one is I. We have to match the subject I with the given predicates. So look at the predicate column. Which one is suitable for the first one? Which one? Yes, you're right. The first one is I know how to climb a tree. This is the correct predicate for the given subject. So what you want to do means you want to write the number near to the word tree. So no need to draw a line, okay? Just write the number 1 near to the option E. Yes. Okay, let's move to the second one, my brother. So which one is correct? Let us match the first subject with the first predicate, okay? My brother has been to Agra. Yes, you're right. The correct predicate for the subject is my brother has been to Agra. So you have to write the number 2 near to the first option A. Write the number 1 near to the option A. Okay, let's move to the third one, the baby. So which one is correct for the baby? Which option is correct? The baby is playing with a teddy bear. So this is the correct predicate for the baby. The baby is playing with a teddy bear. So what number you want to write? Yes, you have to write the number 3. You have to write number 3 in the option J. Is playing with a teddy bear. Near to the word teddy bear, you have to write the number 3. Let's move to the fourth one, she. So, which is the correct predicate for the subject she? She is wearing a beautiful dress. So, this is the correct answer. First of all, you have to match, you have to just see, just you have to match with all the predicates, then only you can easily find which one is correct for the given subject. So she is wearing a beautiful dress. So write the number 4 near to the word dress. Write the number 4. Let's move to the fifth one, Karan. So what is the correct predicate? Yes, Karan wants to be a doctor, because already 4 predicates over. Because already 4 predicates are over, remaining we have to check with remaining 6 predicates. So Karan wants to be a doctor. So write the number 5 near to the word doctor. Let's move to the 6th one, the annual sports day. Yes, we can easily find that the annual sports day was held on Friday. So write the number 6 near to the word Friday. That is option B. Let's move to the 7th one, the scared girl. The scared girl screamed when she saw a spider. The scared girl screamed when she saw a spider. So write the number 7 near to the word spider. That is option D. Write the number 7 near to the word spider. That is option D. Let's move to the 8th one, the travelers. The travelers, remaining 3 options are there, you can easily find the answer. The travelers reached an hour late. So write the number 8 near to the word late. That is option C. Now the 9th one is the bank. Remaining we have 2 options. One is gave Srinath a loan, and remaining and another one is by the stadium. Yes, we know very well that the correct answer is gave Srinath a loan. The bank gave Srinath a loan. It means you have to write the number 9 near to the word loan. That is option G. And the last one is our school. The subject is our school. Remaining predicate is by the stadium. So we should write the number 10 near to the word stadium. That is option F. Okay, students. Once again, I'm saying all the answers. I'm saying the sentences. So, just listen carefully. I know how to climb a tree. That is, you have to write the number F. Write the number 1 near to the F. E. Not F, E. Let's move to the second one. My brother has been to Agra. That is, write the number 2 near to, in the first option, A. Let's move to the third one. The baby is playing with a teddy bear. That is, write the number 3 in the J option, option J. Let's move to the fourth one. She is wearing a beautiful dress. Write the number 4 in the option I. Let's move to the fifth one. Karan wants to be a doctor. Write the number 5 in the option H. Next one. The annual sports day was held on Friday. Write the number 6 on the option B. Let's move to the seventh one. The scared girl screamed when she saw a spider. Write the number 7 in the option D. And the next one is, the travelers reached an hour late. Write the number 8 in the option C. And the ninth one is, the bank gave Srinath a loan. Write the number 9 near to the option G. And the next and the last one, our school is by the stadium. Write the number 10 near to the option F. Students, now this exercise is over. Write the numbers neatly and properly. Don't draw the lines, okay? Just write the numbers near to the given options. Students, now we are going to see the subject in a command or request sentence, okay? In command or request sentences, the subject you is often understood and not stated. So what they are telling means, in command or request sentences, the subject is you. We should understood, okay? It not stated, but we should understood that the subject is you. Let us see the examples here. Shut the door. The sentence is shut the door and it is a command. It's a command. But sometimes we can confuse ourselves. There is no subject. How can we find the subject? So that's why they are telling that in command or request sentences, the subject is you. We should understand that, but it is not stated. So the subject is, you shut the door. We should understand like that. The subject is you. And then move to the next sentence. Please bring me a glass of water. Please bring me a glass of water. So this is a request sentence. So what I said, in command or request sentence, the subject is you. You please bring me a glass of water. We should understood, okay? It is not stated directly, but we should understand that the subject is you in command or request sentences. Okay, students, let's see an exercise. Tick the sentences where the subject is understood. Actually, before we have seen that subject in command or request sentences. These exercises related to command or request sentences. They said that tick the sentences where the subject is understood. It means command or request sentences you should tick. You should tick the command or request sentences. Let us do the first one. The frog is sitting on the lotus leaf. We know very well that frog is the subject. So this is not a command or request sentence. So this is a normal sentence. We should not tick. Okay. Just leave the box empty. Let's move to the second one. Please enjoy your dinner with your family. So this is a request sentence. Please enjoy your dinner with your family. already said that in command or request sentences, the subject is you. We should understand, but they do not state it. So you should tick the second one. Just put a tick mark on the second box. That is, second one is the request sentences where the subject is understood. And the third one is, don't speak loudly in the corridor. Don't speak loudly in the corridor. It means, what type of sentence is this? This is command sentence. So the subject must be you in the third one. The subject is you. So tick the tick mark. So put a tick mark on the third one. Let's move to the fourth one. Write the answers correctly. So this is also we have understood the subject. So put a tick mark on the fourth one. Let's move to the fifth one. One of the boys is absent today. One of the boys is absent today. So we know very well that the subject, but this is not command or request sentence. So no need to do anything. Just leave the box empty. Let's move to the sixth one. Buy a new pair of spectacles. Spectacles means specs. Buy a new pair of spectacles. It means you buy a new pair of spectacles. So what you have to do? Put a tick mark inside the box. That is sixth one. Put a tick mark. So what are the correct answers in the given sentence? Second one. So you please enjoy your dinner with your family. So put a tick mark in the second one. You don't speak loudly in the corridor. So this is also correct answer. So put a tick mark on the third one. You write the answers correctly. That is fourth one. You buy a new pair of spectacles. That is sixth one. So put a tick mark inside the boxes. Second one, third one, fourth one, and sixth one. So these four sentences are either command or request sentences. So write neatly, students. Students, now we came to an end of this chapter. It means recap corner. Before going to recall this chapter, I want to say something. All of you take the page number 33 in your grammar book. Page number 33 in grammar book. Okay. In page number 33, there is an activity. It is for you. What is that activity? That is, let us write. It means complete the following sentences. They have given some sentences with an empty dashes. What you want to do means you have to complete the sentence. You have to complete the sentence, then only it will become meaningful. So students, read the sentence properly and write the words which make the sentence meaningful and complete sentence. Okay, now let's recall this chapter. Today we have seen a sentence and then subject and predicate. Before going to subject and predicate, let us recall the sentence. What do you mean by sentence? Yes, a sentence is a group of words which makes complete sense. What do you mean by sentence? A sentence is a group of words which makes complete and meaningful sentence. And one more thing, you just keep it in your mind. Don't forget that whenever you are writing a sentence or whenever you are starting a sentence, it starts with a capital letter and ends with a full stop or question mark or an exclamation mark. And next one is, sentence has two parts. Already we said that sentence can be divided into two parts. One is subject and another one is predicate. How many parts are there? Two parts. They are subject and the predicate. What do you mean by subject? As already we said that the subject tells us who or what the sentence is about. It tells whom or what the sentence is about. It is known as subject. Simply, how can we say subject will be a noun or pronoun? Let's move to the predicate. What do you mean by predicate? Predicate tells about the subject. it means what the subject is doing, or otherwise what the subject is. It tells something about the subject. So that is known as predicate. And already we have seen lots of examples. And the last one is the subject in a command or request sentence. If the subject in a command or request sentence, we understood that the subject is you. It is not stated directly in the sentence, but we should understood. Okay, let's see an example here. Shut the door. The given sentence is shut the door. It is a command. We know very well that the given sentence is a command. So in this sentence, the subject is you. It is not stated, but we should understood that the subject is you. Okay, students, write all the exercise neatly in your grammar book. Don't overwrite the words. Use pencil. Students, in grammar, today we have completed 7th chapter, that is subject and predicate. Today we have completed all the exercises and we have seen a lot of examples. Now we know very well that what is sentence and what is subject and predicate. We know very well now. I hope you have written neat and clear in your grammar book also. We will meet on next class with another topic. Thank you.